This is part two of solving quadratic equations using the quadratic formula. And in this video, we use the quadratic formula to solve these two quadratic equations. All right, we're going to solve this quadratic equation using the quadratic formula. The first thing we need to do is set the equation equal to zero. So we need to subtract four from both sides to have 8m squared minus 3m minus 4 equal to zero. And now we need to identify our variables a, b, and c, which are the coefficients. So we have a is equal to 8, b is equal to negative 3, and c is equal to negative 4. All right, so we want to plug that in to the quadratic equation, which if you know the song, you can sing it to get it, which I'll do, or you can just write it. It's x equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. Okay, so there's the quadratic formula. You don't have to sing it. And now we're going to plug in the values for a, b, and c. Okay, so this big old fraction bar, I'm going to have the opposite of b. Now b is negative 3, so I plug in negative 3 for b. Plus or minus. And then I'm going to do b squared. So you could either write negative 3 times negative 3 or put in parentheses negative 3 squared. Don't forget to put a parentheses around the negative 3 if you write it this way. Minus 4 times a times c. Now a is 8 and c is negative 4. And that's all under the square root. And then the denominator is 2 times a, so I have 2 times 8. Okay, so that's just plugging in the values for a, b, and c into the quadratic formula. And now we want to simplify the numerator and denominator. So I have the opposite of negative 3, so that's 3 plus or minus. And then under the square root, I have a negative 3 squared. Remember, that means negative 3 times negative 3, 9. And then I have minus 4 times 8 times negative 4. So that's going to be a plus. And you have 4 times 8 times 4, 32 times 4, that's 128. All over 2 times 8, which is 16. Almost done. We need to simplify inside that square root. 9 plus 128 is 137, all over 16. And you see if you could simplify square root of 137, but you can't because there's no perfect square. It's a factor of 137. So we've got two solutions. Three plus the square root of 137 over 16, and 3 minus the square root of 137 all over 16, and that's our answer. Now, a lot of people get kind of confused with all this mess here in the beginning when you're filling in all the numbers, so I'm going to show you another way you can approach it. Going to start out the same equation after I subtract 4 from both sides, and I've identified the coefficients a, b, and c. What I do is I figure out the part that goes underneath the square root first. So I kind of get that all out of the way. So b squared is going to be negative 3 times negative 3. Instead of writing it out as a negative 3 parentheses squared, I could do that in my head. B squared is negative 3 times negative 3, or 9, minus 4 times AC. And then also, I just multiply A times C. 8 times negative 4, which is negative 32. So it's just a little bit, less of a mess. And now I need to simplify that. So that'll be 9, well, a negative times a negative here, that's going to be a plus, right? 128, or 137. So by doing this, when I'm now going to plug it into the quadratic formula, I already know that's the number that's going to go underneath the square root. All right, also, I know in the quadratic formula it's negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. So when I plug it in, I'm going to do negative b. I'm going to look up here and I'm going to say, well, b is negative 3, so negative b would be the opposite of that, positive 3, plus or minus the square root of, well, that's what I already figured out, so that's what goes underneath the square root right here, the 137. And then the denominator is 2a. Okay, so I look up here, 2 times 8 is 16. And it's just a little bit faster. Notice how quick it is to write the answer. So I do a little bit of figuring out ahead of time, and I still have the same two solutions as I did it right here. 3 plus radical 137 over 16, and 3 minus radical 37 over 16. So same exact answer. Two ways of showing your work. All right, here's our next example. We're going to solve by using the quadratic formula. So the first step is set the equation equal to 0. X squared minus 4x minus 8 equals 0. And then we're going to identify A, B, and C. So remember, those are the coefficients. So the coefficient of x squared is 1. The coefficient of the x is negative 4. And the constant is negative 8. So we're going to plug that into the quadratic formula. Remember, the quadratic formula is negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a, which of course you could sing to remember that. So what do we have? X equals, all right, so it says the opposite of b. B is negative 4, plus or minus b squared, so that would be negative 4 squared, minus 4 times a, times c, which is negative 8, all over 2 times a, which is 2 times 1. All right, so we have the opposite of negative 4, that is 4 plus or minus the square root of, all right, now inside the square root, we have to square negative 4. Negative 4 times negative 4 is 16. You have a minus 4 times 1 times negative 8, that's going to be a plus 32, all over 2 times 1, which is 2. Okay, and remember, you could have figured out the b squared minus 4ac first and figured out that this number underneath the square root is going to be 48. And that's your next step now, is to go ahead and simplify underneath the square root. So I have 4 plus or minus square root of 48 all over 2. All right, now we need to simplify the square root of 48. Remember that 48 is 16 times 3, so just keep in mind, square root of 48 would be the square root of 16 times 3, which is the square root of 16 times the square root of 3, so it would be 4 square roots of 3. So that's what I'm going to do over here. I'm going to write this is 4 plus or minus 4 square roots of 3 all over 2. Okay. Our next step is to simplify this fraction. Now, to simplify fractions, what you do is you can factor and cancel. So that's what we're going to do. So we're looking at the numerator here, and I could factor out a 4. And cancel the 4 and the 2 now. And now I've got to do the distributive property. 2 times 1 is 2, plus or minus 2 times square root of 3 is 2 square root of 3. And that gives me two solutions, 2 plus 2 square root of 3, and 2 minus 2 square root of 3. Now, you notice I started writing this 4 plus or minus 4 root 3 over 2 again down here. I'm I'm going to show you another way. Since this is a fraction with a binomial in the numerator, you could put each term in the numerator over the denominator. So I have 4 over 2 plus or minus 4 squared, so 3 over 2. And then you would cancel each of those. 4 over 2 is 2. And then this 4 over 2 is also 2. So you have 2 plus or minus 2 squared, so 3. That also works.